خیلی کپی من داد و تا تو کردیم نامه کلای برز لاجان کشکشی دکات و انشالله ملاجه سر پرشتی و چاو دیری دکتر کوان و انشالله دست بیاکین اگر بکرید کار لاجان مختیتی کرد و پختیک من پیشم دی و ماوی چاره یک تان زخیر بله بسر بله بسر بله
بسر My name is Lajan Burhan Abdalla, and I graduated in Building Construction Engineering, University of Sulaimani in 2012. The research title is Effect of Powder Polymer on Stress Strain Behavior, Shear and Flexural Strains of Simply Supporting Reinforced Concrete Beams at Different Curing Edges. The outline of the presentation is started with the introduction, material and equipment used in study, the experimental program, test and result, conclusion and recommendation, and achievement and publication during this study. We'll start from introduction. The objective of the research mainly is enhancing the mechanical properties of the normal strength concrete using powder polymer and achieving early age concrete strength and increasing the shear and bending capacity of simply supported reinforced concrete beam at different curing age, especially at early age. Finally, producing new type of concrete, which is modified concrete, with a better properties in both and fresh, hard, in both fresh and hardened state. The variable of the study, different water to cement ratio was taken in this study. The different type and percentage of powdered polymer was used in study is another variable, and different curing time from 1 day up to 28 days was taken into consideration. This is another variable of the study. Literature review. In the literature, different kind of additive and admixture was used to modify the cement and concrete properties. In our study, the effect of most common additive, which is the silica fume and fly ash, was taken and their effect on the properties of concrete study. Based on the collected data, the statistical analysis was performed also. In the literature, the silica fume was used up to 40% to replace the cement and to modify the properties of concrete, and fly ash up to 60% was used also to replace the cement and to modify the properties of concrete and cement. Material and equipment that used in the study. Ordinary Portland cement from the Gas and Cement Company was used. Fine and coarse aggregate locally was used also. Six different types of powder polymer also used as shown here. Polycarboxylate type water reducer superplasticizer. The concrete strain gauge and thin strain gauge was also used to measure the concrete in the strain and measure the strain in the steel bar during the test. Linear displacement transducer and steel bar also was used for the simply supported beam, and the linear transducer was used to measure the deflection and strain in the concrete during the test. Load cell data logger and compression machine also was used to test the simply supported beam as shown here, and this is an interface of the data logger program. The experimental program of the study can be divided into two main parts, material and structural. The material part also divided into cement modified with polymer and concrete modified with polymer. In the concrete part, the high dosage and low dosage of concrete of polymer was used to modify the concrete properties. In the structural part, the effect of different dosage and different type of powder polymer on the behavior of shear and bending of simply supported concrete beam at different curing age, 3 days, 7 days, and 28 days, was taken into consideration. Test and result. Cement modified with polymer. In this part, the cement was modified with polymer using different dosages from 0 up to 0.25%. Different curing time from 1 day up to 28 days was taken into consideration. And different dosage and different polymer, six times was used. We can see that the compressive strength at early age of cement was enhanced significantly from 23 megapascal up to 68 megapascal, which is very good enhancement in 3 days. And the same enhancement was achieved in 28 days. You can see from 40 megapascal, the compressive strength of cement enhanced up to 90 megapascal as shown. The serpentine flowability and consistency test also for cement modified with polymer was performed and also enhanced. The photos can be seen during the preparation, the mold and testing in the lab. Test and result for concrete modified with polymer. In this stage, the concrete also modified with polymer, which is trial stage. In this stage, concrete also modified with six different types of polymer. This three and this is another three one. Different dosage also was taken into consideration from 0 up to 0.25. And different curing time also taken into consideration from 1 day up to 28 days. We can see at 3 days, which is very important, the compressor strength is enhanced from 20 megapascal up to 39 megapascal, which is a good improvement. Same improvement was achieved in 28 days. The compressive strength of concrete enhanced from 34 megapascal up to 15 megapascal. These two graphs show the relation between compressive strength of concrete and percentage of polymer at different curing time. You can see at 3 days and 28 days, the polymer B and polymer F was the most effective one on increasing the compressive strength. At 28 days, also polymer B and polymer F are same effective compared with the others. So we selected, based on this, we selected the polymer B and polymer F for the next stages, which is performing the detailed test of the concrete and finding the effect on the shear and bending of simply supported concrete beam at different perimeters. Some photos from the lab during the testing the cube compressive strength and slump for the concrete. Concrete modified with low dosages. At this stage, we modified the concrete with low dosages. We selected 0.15 and 0.25 percentage. We selected polymer B and polymer F. From here, we changed the name to polymer A and polymer B. We can see the workability of fresh concrete enhanced significantly from 82 mm to 150, and the water seal ratio at the same time was reduced from 0.6 to 0.46. The compressive strength, cylindrical compressive strength, is enhanced using different percentage of polymer low dosage at different curing time. Can see as shown here. The flexural strength of concrete also enhanced using low dosage of powder polymer at different curing time. Using high dosage of powder polymer for modified the concrete, which is 0.45% and 0.75%, we can see the workability also enhanced from 175 up to 215. The water cement ratio was increased and same amount of cement content was used, which is 350. We can see the compressive strength of concrete, cubic compressive strength, at different curing time from 3 days up to 28 days. We achieved a significant improvement in the compressive strength, especially at 28 days. We have improvement from 28 megapascal up to 61 megapascal. In 3 days also we have a very good enhancement, which is from 15 increases up to 46 megapascal at 3 days, which is, you can see here we have an early edge compressive strength. The important point in this big achievement and improvement was achieved only by using 380 kilograms of cement for all the mixes. So the improvement was due to using the small percentage of polymer in the mixes, which is reducing the water content and at the same time improving the workability. This is a very important point in the study, which is desired economically and environmentally. And this graph shows the growth in 3 days and 7 days, which you can see at 3 days we have 210% growth in compressive strength. Same result was achieved using high dosage of polymer for the critical compressive stress of concrete. Shape failure for the cube and for the cylinder and preparation prepping for the critical sample. Flexural strength of concrete using high dosage of polymer was enhanced, and you can see from this figure show that the crack pass through the gravel and breaking the gravel. This means that the cement base was strong enough that the crack cannot pass through the cement base. The splitting tensile strength, it is another property of concrete, it's important also enhance it using the hydrosurge of powdered polymer, especially at 3D. This graph shows the percentage of growth in split tensile strength. At 3D, we have up to 200% growth. Stress strain behavior of the concrete modified with polymer, we can see this graph for the control sample. The area under curve of the stress strain curve for the control sample is much less than the area under curve for the concrete modified with polymer, which is mean that the concrete modified with polymer can absorb more energy and carry more load during the testing. Test and result for the structural part, which is the core part of this study. Different type of polymer and different percentage, high and low. The effect on the behavior of shear and bending at 3 days, 7 days was 3 days, 7 days, 28 days was steady. We have a beam design for shear failure control. Our beam is 115 centimeter in length and 20 centimeter in width and 30 centimeter in depth. We have this is a beam design for bending failure control. And this is a typical section of beam under the test, which is, you can see the beam was loaded with a point load at the center, and 4 LDT was fixed to the beam, one under the point load directly to measure the deflection, and the others to measure the crack opening during the test. Also, stick strain gauge was fixed in the steel up and in the main bar to measure the strain in the concrete in the steel bar during the test. Using low dosages of powder polymer, for this purpose, 30 beam was casted and tested to find the effect of shear and bending effect at different curing time, and different doses was taken into consideration. We can see the bending capacity for the beam using low dosage of polymer, there's no improvement for 3 days, 7 days, and 28 days. While for the shear capacity for the simply supporting beam at 3 days and 7 days, there's improvement in the bend in the shear capacity for the beam, but at 28 days there is no improvement. Based on these two results, we proposed a high dosage of polymer, which is 0.45 and 0.75, to find their effect on the shear and bending behavior. Another 30 beams was casted again with high dosages, which is 0.45 and 0.75, to measure and find the effect on the bending capacity. You can see bending capacity using high dosage of polymer increase it slightly in the 3 days, 7 days, and 28 days, and this is show the growth in bending capacity. This is shape failure of the beam failure due to bending, and at the shear failure, we achieved a very good enhancement in shear capacity in 3 days, 7 days, and 28 days. You can see achievement here, the percentage of growth at 3 days, 110% growth in shear capacity was achieved. At 7 days also, at 28 days, we have improvement. This graph shows the combination between load and deflection for 3 days and 28 days. Here you can see that the area under curve for the control sample compared to the others is much lower, which is mean that the concrete modified with polymer can absorb more energy during the test, and the deflection at same load is deflected, is reduced for the concrete modified with polymer compared to the control sample. Here we have we fixed 2 LDT to measure the crack opening during the test, and shape failure for the beam failed due to shear. Some photo during the work in progress. Conclusion and our recommendation. Semi-modified with polymer setting time, flow quality and density of cement phase increases significantly. The compressive strength of cement increases also significantly. At 3 days we have growth in compressive strength 195%. At 28 days we have 125% growth. For the concrete, workability of fresh concrete and density of hardened concrete also improved significantly using polymer. Using low dosage of polymer improved the compressive strength at 3 days, which is the growth 98% and 93%, which we can see we have early age concrete, early age strength concrete at this stage. the flexural strength and subducting tensile strength also improved using polymer. Using high dosage of polymer also improved the concrete compressive strength. And shear strength capacity for simply support being significantly improved, while the flexural strength capacity partially improved using powder polymer for simply support. Our recommendation to the other future researchers using powder polymer for producing high stress concrete and self-compacted concrete. Using powder polymer for producing high performance concrete using supplementary cementitious material. And investigating the effect of powder polymer on compressive stress of concrete at high temperature. Finally, using powder polymer to modify the normal stress concrete for column application, because column is a compression member and polymer have is very effective in improving the compressive strength. Our publication and achievement during the last 2 years was participating in two international conferences. The first one, 10th International Conference on Polycarboxylate Supercarboxylate in Munich, Germany, which is prepared by Munich University. The second was 4th International Conference on Building and Construction and Environment in the Istanbul, Turkey. And 8th publication in the International Journal was published during the last 2 years. Finally, I want to express my thanks to Gas and Cement Company, which is they are the main sponsor for this study. And my thanks to the Gas and Cement Team Lab also. Finally, I have a short video I want to share with you, which is show the work in progress during the study.
just for stash.